Good morning children, you all are welcome to the social class. In this class we are going to see the fourth lesson from Around the World. Lesson number 4, Agriculture. Do you know agriculture? If a country not having the agriculture, there a human being or birds, animals, nothing can be live. The biosphere will be nothing because when the agriculture goes to an end, the humanity, the life will be end to the human and birds and animals. So the agriculture is very important to the world. Now we can learn the factors influence the agriculture. Relief, climatic conditions, soil, economic factors and some other factors are there. First, the relief. Land on which crops are grown is known as the arable land, where the crops are growing. That land is called as the arable land. You see, some factors are affecting. What are the factors? The people are using the lands for building, for constructing the houses and the factories and at all, no? And the farming is goes to end. The soil is very important and the climatic condition is very important. If there is heavy rainfall at the time of the sowing seeds or the farming time, there will be affect the agriculture. And the types of farming. What are the types of farming? The subsistence farming, intensive farming, extensive farming and shifting cultivation, then commercial farming, then plantation agriculture. Commercial farming means these crops are used to the export and import, no? That is, they are the this type of crops tax the first place, that is the rubber and at all, okay? Then we can see the types of crops. What are the types of crops? There are the food crops, cash crops. Then what are the cash crops? The food crops. Food crops means we are using these crops to eat, okay? The wheat, rice, vegetables, fruits, these are the food crops. What is that cash crops? That cash crops means that is used to in the industries, okay, and the that is sell in the market, that is used as a raw materials, that cotton, jute, these things are comes in the cash crops. Sugarcane, tea and coffee also the examples, but sugarcane, tea and coffee we are using for food, but jute and cotton we will not use for food, no? Okay, then major crops. What are the major crops? Rice, wheat, cotton, sugarcane, jute, tea, coffee, rubber. These are the major crops. Rice, throughout the world we need rice. Where are the Tamil people, the Indian people are living? We need wheat and rice. The tea, daily we are using tea. That is one of the main cash crop also. Then the sugar cane. That Cuba is called as the sugar bowl. Why? They are producing only sugar and they are selling this sugar and they are getting rich because of this sugar only. Cotton is one of the cash crop. Jute is one of the cash crop. We are using these crops to produce the as a material raw materials in the industries. Jute and cotton, coffee and tea is a very important crops to export. It will increase the financial condition. Then we can see the Green Revolution. What is called as Green Revolution? Dr. Norman Ernest Borlaug is an agronomist. He has developed high yielding varieties of seeds, that is wheat seeds, in the year 1951 in Mexico. So he is called as the father of green revolution. In India, Dr. Swaminathan is the father of green revolution. Then the green revolution was successful in Punjab, Haryana and western Uttar Pradesh. In these places we are producing the wheat, and in Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh what we are producing? Rice. The green revolution helped not only to enhance production but also to improve the general, social and economic conditions of farmers and their families, because when they are getting the high yield varieties of crops, then only they can get more crops and they can produce more crops, now then only they can sell this for a good so because of that only the level of the farmers will be increase in economically, the farmer family also comes to the good level. So the green revolution give the better life to the farmers. Okay.